Tonight, on behalf of Active Sussex, we celebrate what has been a fantastic year of sporting achievement. London 2012 was a great success, all the way from Jessica Ennis to Mo Farah. But we do concentrate more on local heroes tonight, as 10-year anniversary for Active Sussex and some fantastic prestigious awards are handed out.
I just love watching people and be inspired by how I was with regards to sport, no matter what it is, because I'm also a PE teacher as well. So I just like watching young people, adults, whoever, just being inspired to give something a go.
And we went to a school in the slums in Nairobi in April and literally just took our Olympic legacy to them. Did Olympic Games, football tournaments, taught them other sports. We gave them the stuff to carry it on year after year so they could make their Olympic.
Okay, so today marks a very special occasion in my life beyond anything else, because this is the first time I've actually been able to hold an Olympic medal. And I'm a little bit in awe, to be honest. It's a lot heavier than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, they are extremely heavy, very well made, and it's a real honour to have one for myself.
Of course it is. Now, I know it's an achievement in any regard, but obviously there were some extenuating circumstances for you. Could you talk us through those a little bit, please?
Yeah, I was unfortunate to have ruptured my MCL and ACL, two major ligaments in my knee. In fairness, given the circumstances and on reflection, a bronze medal to be there was, for me, quite remarkable. So, yeah, I'm happy.
I'm here with Sadie Mason, Chief Executive of Active Sussex. Sadie, tell us more about this evening.
Well, this evening's all about honouring and doing all things great and grand about 2012. So basically, we've had the Olympics, it's a Queen's Jubilee year. What greater time to actually honour people locally who have either been involved in the Olympics or actually been involved in bringing those Olympians through, from grassroots coaches, volunteers, club administrators. We're all here tonight to honour them.
Okay, so I feel a little bit overwhelmed right now, I'm not going to lie. This is the, I've just held Ben Quilter's medal, and every time it's a bit of a surprise how heavy it actually is. When they finally put it around your neck, what was that feeling like?
Well, it was fine when it was around your neck, but when we were canting around, waving to the crowds in the lap of honour, riding a horse, that swung up and nearly knocked my front teeth out. So I'm like, okay, this is quite heavy and solid.
That would do some damage.
Yeah, that would do some damage. You think I've survived the cross country and not getting knocked out or anything, and I get knocked out by my medal, it wouldn't be good, would it?
Oh, well, it's a story to tell anyway, isn't it, really? Can you just talk us through your year, please? It must have been amazing.
It has been an amazing year. You know, as I said earlier, the horse was very ill the year before and very nearly died, so I wasn't expecting to show at the Olympics. I'd sort of come to terms with it mentally that I probably wouldn't go. And when he recovered so well and to get into the team was amazing. Look, it was frustrating because we'd like to have won gold, like any athlete that were there, but to come away with the silver was amazing, and the whole experience was unbelievable.
And obviously this year has been a fantastic year for judo overall. Mm-hmm. It's going to mean so much for the sport in the future, is it not?
You know, the whole team in general, you know, did really well, and British Judo hopefully will move on to much bigger and better things in the future.